Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. In this example, I want to build a confidence interval using proportions to estimate the population proportion. And I'm using this example to build a confidence interval, but I have seven different things I'm going to answer for you, including point estimate, margin of error, confidence level. And so I want to be able to talk about a lot of vocabulary in this. Okay, the chief of police in a city asked for more money and said that 75% of the residents did not feel comfortable to walk in their neighborhoods after dark. A city poll asked respondents if they felt uncomfortable walking in their neighborhood after dark. In the poll, N is 875, that's the number of people that responded, and of those, 510 said yes. Yes, they feel uncomfortable, because that's what the chief of police said, that residents did not feel comfortable. So yes, they feel uncomfortable. Use a 95% confidence level and answer the next seven questions. Find the best point estimate of the population proportion. The best point estimate is the sample proportion. So to find that, we take the number of yeses divided by the total number. So 510 divided by 875 gives us 0.583. That's the percentage in our sample that said they felt uncomfortable walking around at night. Identify the margin of error. The margin of error for a proportion is this. The critical value Z is alpha over 2. And then the square root of p hat q hat over n. We just found p hat. So now we can find q hat by subtracting p hat from 1. 1 minus 0.583 is how I got 0.417. Also, we're given n, which is in our formula. So all we need to do is find the critical value, which is the critical value comes directly from our confidence level, which is 95%. I calculated this in previous videos, so I'm not going to do it here. 90, 95, and 99 are well-known values. If you're given any of those three confidence levels, then you can quickly know the value without having to do the calculation if you keep that little chart near you. So for 95%, the critical value is 1.96. 1.960, so we just leave it there. So now I'm going to plug all those things into my margin of error formula. Critical value of 1.96, p hat 0.583, q hat 0.417, n 875. I do this calculation on my calculator and I get 0.033. That's the margin of error. The next thing I want to do is construct the confidence interval and values rounded to three places. So my confidence interval is my p hat minus e on the left side and then p hat plus E on the right side. So if I do that subtraction, I get 0.550, and that addition, I get 0.583 plus 0.033 is 0.616. What does this interval mean? If you were asked to interpret this interval, what you would say is we are 95% confident that this interval contains the actual value of the population proportion. In other words, we're 95% sure that the actual number of people, percentage-wise, that are afraid to go out of their house at night are contained in this interval somewhere, the proportion of people that are not comfortable walking around at night. Does this confidence interval support the report from the chief of police? Our interval does not contain 75%. And that's what she claimed, that the 75% of the people did not feel comfortable walking around. So it does not seem to support, in fact, it seems to contradict a little bit the report from the chief of police, because our value of 75% does not fall within here. And we're 95% confident that the actual value does fall in our interval. If the chief of police had said over half of the citizens are not comfortable walking around the city instead of the 75%, would our findings support her statement then? I think we probably could say over half. Yeah, it looks like a little over half of the people, maybe, right? Over half. Maybe we could say that. But since our interval is over half, half would be 50%, right? We're over that. So we might be able to say, if she had said that, instead of going all 75% on us, that we would be able to support that. If we used a 90% confidence level rather than a 95%, would the interval be wider or narrower? Well, we would be saying that we were less confident if we use 90%. So we could actually make the range more narrow. And I went ahead and did the calculations for that using 90%. And you can see that if I did use 90%, instead of 0.550, I'd be at 0.556. So a little bit higher or closer to P on this side. And then instead of 0.616, I'm at 0.610. So a little closer in on this side as well. So not a lot different, but a little narrower because we're not trying to be as confident. All right, there's a lot of vocabulary in that, a lot to digest, but it's a great example to go back to because it answers many questions that are going to be on your homework. Have a fantastic day. And remember to subscribe if you want to keep up with the new videos that I'm posting.